Of Antiguan chicken, and also we are making red beans and rice, and these are our main ingredients here. I have some parsley, some red and green pepper, tomatoes, shallots, red onions, garlic and cloves, some green onions. And I made a pineapple chutney there, spicy pineapple chutney, and it was cooked down with white balsamic vinegar, reduced. So it's a little tangy and sweet and hot. And what I've done today is we're gonna make a chicken stock, and I'm not actually gonna make it completely, but I'm just gonna go through a process of how it's done. I took the back out of the chicken, and I put it in a pan with an onion. This is the back of the chicken and carrots. And I'm gonna put that onto the broiler and broil it and add water to it with some chicken stock and just cook it down, making a stock for the recipe. I've already made the stock beforehand, so we're not gonna go through the process of making the stock. I just wanted to show how we put it together here. Okay, well, our chicken stock is on the go now, and I already made chicken stock cooked down, but the bones from the chicken that I just had on the broiler and browned it, I decided just to put it back into the stock, which had been reduced. So we just, you know, I don't want to waste the flavors from the chicken, so I want to just get as much as I can out of it and probably increase my stock a little bit. I'm just gonna put through some parsley in there and just give it some flavor, and have a bay leaf also, a little bit of bay leaf, I'll throw it in there. So we're gonna let that cook down for a little bit. In the meantime, we're gonna put our chicken to broil. Rice and peas together now, so here we go. I'm gonna put a splash of olive oil in the pan. We got some red onions, so I'm gonna put the red onions in. Some green onions. We have put a few cloves in there. Say about 3 or 4 cloves. Go in there. Lower the heat a little. Before we get them juices out of them. You want to burn them. You want to get them nicely. I think we'll put some garlic in there. I got this great garlic press. It was a good. Okay. It's a good investment, this garlic press. It really does its job. Now, I've washed my rice. So before I do that, let me put the red beans in. I got these from a can, and they're pretty good. Pretty good. This particular can is some organic beans, red beans, but you can use any beans as long as they're red beans. I've used the ones in the can because it's quicker. And so we're gonna let that simmer down for a little bit before we put the rice in. Here we have 1.5 cups of rice. And this is a basmati rice, and I've washed it thoroughly. So we're gonna put it into the pot, okay? So let's stir that around a little bit. In there. Now, the can that the peas came in had this sauce in it, which I think it's we're gonna put this into the pot because it's gonna give it that color that we need, that nice red color that we need. So we're gonna put that in there. Here we have some chicken stock. We have 1.5 cups of rice here, so we're gonna put these 2 cups of chicken stock into the pan. Okay, and we're gonna stir it. And we're gonna bring it to the boil, and we'll cover it over and simmer it until it's done. At this point here, I'm gonna put some salt. I got some kosher salt here, so I'm gonna put some salt in there, and a dash of soy sauce. Just a dash. So we will let that come get to the boil, and then we'll simmer it down. Put it in a low fire until it's cooked. Our chicken is ready now, so we're gonna take it out of the oven. There we go. Beautiful. We've removed the chicken from the pan, and as you can see, there's lots of juices from the chicken in there. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put it back in the fire and caramelize it slightly, and pour some white wine and reduce it, and that'll be the base for our sauce. So we're gonna bring it over here and put it on the fire. Okay, our juices are beginning to caramelize. If you can look and see, that it's going getting slightly brown in there. So this is the point where we need to put our white wine. So we're gonna simmer that down until when the wine almost evaporates from the pan, and then we're gonna add our chicken stock to that. Put it into another pan, and we'll reduce it, and that'll be our sauce. Okay, the wine is almost evaporated, as you can see. And at this point here, we're gonna put the chicken stock in. I'm just gonna pour it in. My spoon, and dislodge all the little caramelized bits off the pan. And then we're gonna strain it and put it back into the pot, and we will reduce it, and that'll be the basis for our sauce today. We've sauteed the shallots and the red pepper and green pepper. And we're gonna add the stock. We're gonna add the tomatoes to it, and let that cook down for a little while. Our tomatoes are sort of stewing down now. Now I'm using some tomatoes in this dish, basically just to sort of give it some body for the sauce. I'm gonna add the stock, chicken stock, and I've added some carrots in the chicken stock. As you can see, I just put some carrots in there. And I'm just gonna pour the chicken stock into the sauteed mixture that I just did. So just gonna go in there like that. I'm gonna turn the heat up a little bit. And we're gonna reduce this down to half, and then we'll slice out our chicken breast and just place them in there and then we're ready to go. Okay, we're putting our dish together. We have the chicken, the rice, and I've added some sweet potato to the dish, which I didn't mention before, but we have some sweet potatoes to go with this dish. I'm gonna spoon some of the sauce that I've made over the rice, or over the chicken itself. We have some of the pineapple chutney. I'm gonna put over the sweet potato. And we have some parsley. And that's our dish.